Yeah, Slack should work. With a red extrusion, of course. And now you just need to get on that green cube as it's moving. Yeah, it would work better if you're on it from the start. So that's what that pressure plate does. Yeah, now you can get to that one. Yeah, it'd probably be better if you're on it, on Ella, on the top, yeah. Right. How many are left? Well, there is one way to find out. It involves looking up. Although, you might want to try pointing a laser behind you while you're standing on that pressure plate, as I think that might be what you need for. Gold item. Although, how to set a fire in order to use the ore stream to open the door, that still eludes me. And it seems to elude you currently as well. Right. Based on the last time we checked that board with the items in this central hub, along with the two that we picked up earlier, only two items remain. Yeah. That's the only way you can make it point this way. Ah, well, at least you know what to do to get to that cube. Although, bouncing up there from the start, that's not possible, I'm afraid. For a good reason. Because you need to stand on here in order to oil the cube. Yeah, the only way I can see this working is if you time it so that you can jump on the oiled cube as it's moving towards you. On the way to the ramp. You know what? I was surprised that you could time that well enough. With the first time you did that. Well, the first time it was oil, anyway. Now all that remains is to figure out how to get that last item. Because there's a lack of fire going on, isn't there? I don't think Bouncy will help here. Certainly not with two cubes. Yes, this might take a while. seeing this from a different angle. Ah. Good thinking, Dr. Cross. Now all you need to do is time it so that the fire moves back just as the oil stream starts a fire. Yeah, it would work best if it was pointing the other way.
Do it.
It works now. Gates open. Right, so that's all the items in the central hub. Looks like you've got 3 rooms to deal with before this is done. As that fan, or rather fans, aren't going to be that much useful to you. At least until everything has been dealt with. Okay. Easily visible items. A less than visible way of getting to them. Okay, that pressure plate moves that, and moves the... middle lift. Yeah, I suspected that... Okay. The fan also controls the first lift. So by elimination, yes, this one controls that and the fan. The last lift and the fan, rather. Figuring out how this fits together. Yes, I believe could probably wait, as right now you've got some items to figure out how to access. And it looks like you found that way. Right. With the silver item, I suspect it requires some creative stacking below the right fan before it's activated by the pressure plates. And then you hop up there. As for the gold item, that requires... you get up here, or rather up there, and ride a cube over there. Based on how this works. Well, at least you know how to set up the fans. Now all you need to do is to figure out how to get to all those items. The silver and the gold one, to be more precise. Well, you get the idea, Dr. Cross. The execution needs little work, though. It needs to be so that you can get up there. Thank you. Yeah. Need to have it in a stack of 1 and then 2. Yes, you can pull this off that way. Not exactly as I expected, but that works. And I think I know what you need to do to get to the gold one. You need to set up all the green cubes on the buttons, and then hop up to where you need to go. Well, all the buttons that matter, anyway. Right. Everything is ready. Yeah, it would be good to know where... Yeah, good. That's all the items here. You just need to work out how to get up to the terminal. Wrong. Yeah, that's the right one. Just need to do the same with the other two, and you've done this. Yes, forgive the silence, Dr. Cross. But I thought it would be more fun to... Sorry. For you to figure out the rest on your own. I mean, compared to the rest of it, it's not that hard, is it? As for what you'll deal with next... That's a matter for debate.